Hello students of Standard 9th. Today we will learn 4.5 Tansen by Hazrat Inayat Khan. Hazrat Inayat Khan is known for his brilliance in poetry and music, yet his deepest inner calling was in spiritual matters. Inayat's early life primarily revolved around music, and he was given many awards and medals of honor for his magnificent singing. I begin with the explanation of the poem. Tansen, the singer in great Akbar's court, won great renown through the Badshahi fort. Now, Tansen was a singer in great King Akbar's court, and he won great renown. Renown means fame. That means he became famous in King Akbar's kingdom, that is the Badshahi fort. His voice rang like the sound of silver bells, and Akbar ravished heard, the story tells. So, King Akbar has compared Tansen's voice with the melodious sound of silver bells. And King Akbar was fascinated. Ravished means fascinated, that after hearing singing of Tansen. How the king praised him, gave him many a gem, called him chief jewel in his diadem. So the King Akbar rewarded Tansen by giving him many gem, that is precious stones, and he also called Tansen as the chief jewel in his diadem. Diadem means crown. So Tansen is one of the nine gems in King Akbar's court. The figure of speech, his voice rang like the sound of silver bells. So here it is direct comparison of Tansen's voice with the sound of silver bells. So it is simile, and the sound of the letter S is repeated, so it is alliteration, and the word bell brings out the ringing sound, so it is onomatopoeia. The next one is called him chief jewel in his diadem. Here Tansen is compared to chief jewel, so it is indirect comparison or implied comparison, so the figure of speech is metaphor. The rhyming words in the stanza are court, fort, bells, tells, gem, diadem. We move to the next three couplets. One day the singer sang the song of fire, the Deepak Rag, and burning like a pyre. So here Tansen was singing the song of fire, that is the Deepak Rag, and he sang it so intensely that he himself was burning like a pile of wood. His body burst into consuming flame. To cure his burning heart, a maiden came. So Tansen was singing so intensely that his body was as if bursting into flame, which is consuming him, engulfing him. And to cure, that is to heal his burning heart, a young unmarried woman came, that is maiden, and sang Malhar, the song of water cold, till health returned and comfort as of old. So this young maiden, she sang the Malhar, that is a rain song, the Malhar Raga, the song of water, cold water. So when she sang, the burning got doused, that means it was put off by the water, and that's how Tansen's health was saved and he came back to normal, comfort as of old. The figure of speech, one day the singer sang the song, the sound of the letter S is repeated, so alliteration. Then to cure his burning heart, a maiden came. The sentence is not in correct prose order, so it is inversion, figure of speech, and the correct prose order is a maiden came to cure his burning heart. The rhyming words in the couplets are fire, pyre, flame, came, cold, old. We move on to the next. Mighty thy teacher must be and divine. Great Akbar said, magic indeed is thine. So, King Akbar called Tansen's teacher mighty, that is great, and divine. Divine means godlike. And there is magic in Tansen's singing. Learnt at his feet, then happy Tansen bowed and said, beyond the world, ignoble crowd. So Tansen told King Akbar that he learnt at his teacher's feet and he respects him. Therefore, he bowed and he said that his teacher is beyond this world's ignoble crowd. Ignoble means not worthy. The crowd, people are not worthy of listening to his teacher. And Tansen's teacher was Swami Haridas. Scorning its wealth, remote and far away, he dwells within a cave of Himalaya. So his teacher rejects, scorning means rejecting the wealth of the world, and he is staying in a remote, far off place, in a cave in the Himalaya mountain. Dwells, that means he stays in the cave of Himalaya mountains. Could I but see him once, desired the king, sit at his feet a while and listening. So King Akbar told Tansen that it is his wish, desire means wish, to listen to his teacher Swami Haridas singing. A while means for some time. Hear his celestial song, I would deny my state and walk in robes of poverty. So King Akbar told Tansen that I want to hear his celestial song, that is heavenly song, divine song, and I am ready to come and visit him in ordinary clothes, robes of poverty, clothes of poor person, and I will not show him that I am a king. I would deny my state. Then said Tansen, as you desire, Huzur, indeed were better as a slave and poor. So even Tansen told King Akbar that if it is your wish, dear king, Huzur is the respect given to the king, indeed it will be better if you dress up like a slave and come as a poor person to visit my teacher. To come, for he lifted above the things of earth, disdains to sing to earthly king. Because his teacher is above the things of the earth, and his teacher does not like to sing to the kings of the earth. He hates. Disdain means hates. Come to the figure of speech. Mighty thy teacher must be and divine. The sound of the letter M and T are repeated for poetic effect. So it is alliteration. Then it is also the sentence is not in correct prose order. So that is inversion. The correct prose order is thy teacher must be mighty and divine. Then we come to the next one. Scorning its wealth, remote and far away. So remote and far away are similar words which are expressed in the same line. So it is tautology. Coming words in the couplets are divine, thine, bowed, crowd, away, Himalay, king, listening, deny, poverty, huzur, poor, things, kings. We move to the next stanza. Long was the road, and Akbar as a slave followed Tansen, who rode towards the cave. So the road was long, and Akbar was dressed like a slave. He followed Tansen, and they both were riding towards the cave. High in the mountains at the singer's feet, they knelt and prayed with supplication sweet. So it was high in the Himalaya mountains, and finally they reached Swami Haridas, and they knelt, that is they bowed, showed their respect, and they also prayed, that means they requested. Supplication is a humble request. So they made a very sweet, humble request to Swami Haridas. Towards thy shrine, lo, we have journeyed long. O holy master, bless us with thy song. So Tansen told his teacher that to come to this holy place, shrine is a holy place, we have journeyed long, means we have traveled a long distance. So he called his teacher, O holy master, and he told him to bless them with thy song. That means they wanted to hear Swami Haridas singing. Then Ustad, won by their humility, sang song of peace and high felicity. So even Tansen's teacher, Swami Haridas, Ustad is Swami Haridas, he also felt and he was won over by the modest appearance of King Akbar. He had dressed in simple clothes and he also was ready and he sang song of peace and high felicity. Felicity means great happiness. Now, Swami Haridas, he sang the Malkas Raga, all ecstatic rang till birds and beasts enchanted as he sang. So, Swami Haridas, when he sang the Malkas Raga, there was overwhelming happiness and birds and animals, they all were delighted to hear Swami Haridas singing. Gathered to hear over Akbar's dreaming soul, he felt the waves of heavenly rapture roll. So all the beasts, all the animals and birds, they gathered to hear Swami Haridas singing and King Akbar was as if in a dream world. His soul felt the waves. He felt the vibration of heavenly rapture roll. Heavenly means divine singing. Intense pleasure of divine singing. But as he turned to speak his words of praise, Ustad had vanished from his wandering gaze. So before King Akbar can even open his mouth and praise Swami Haridas singing, Swami Haridas had already vanished. Vanished means disappeared from his sight. Wandering gaze means from King Akbar's sight. Because he felt that he did not require the praise of earthly kings because he sings for God. We come to the figure of speech. Long was the road and Akbar as a slave is inversion figure of speech. The sentence is not in correct prose order. The correct prose order is the road was long. The next one, they knelt and prayed with supplication sweet, is also inversion. The correct prose order is they knelt and prayed with sweet supplication. And it is also alliteration where the sound of the letter S in supplication and sweet are repeated for poetic effect. Then the next line, towards thy shrine, lo, we have journeyed long. So here also it is inversion. The sentence is not in correct prose order. The correct prose order is we have journeyed long towards thy shrine. Sang song of peace and high felicity. Again the sound of the letter S is repeated. So it is alliteration in sang and songs. Then we come to the next one, the Malkas Raga, all ecstatic rang. Again it is inversion figure of speech. The sentence is not in correct prose order. The correct prose order is the Malkas Raga rang all ecstatic. Then we also have alliteration figure of speech. Sound of letter R in raga and rang is repeated for poetic effect. Then we come to he felt the waves of heavenly rapture roll. The sound of letter R again in rapture and roll is repeated for poetic effect. So it is alliteration. Then Ustad had vanished from his wandering gaze. Here the adjective wandering is transferred from Akbar to his gaze. So it is transferred epithet. Rhyming words are slave, cave, feet, sweet, long, song, humility, felicity, ran, sang, soul, roll, praise, gaze. Move to the last three couplet. Tell me, Tansen, what theme this is that holds the soul enchanted and the heart unfolds. So King Akbar is telling Tansen that what theme, theme means musical composition, that is holding the soul and delighting, enchanted means delighted, and is also enfolding the heart, which means surrounds the heart in high delight. And when he knew the name, tell me again, he said, could you the same? Here King Akbar requested Tansen to sing the same Malkas Raga which his teacher had sung. Theme sing to lure my heart to paths untrod. Ah no, to thee I sing. He sings for God. So his the theme means musical composition. So he told Akbar that I am singing to lure your heart, that is to delight your heart. And it is his teacher who sings for God. The rhyming words of the poem are holds and folds, name same, untrod God. So students, I hope you have enjoyed the poem. I begin with the critical appreciation. The poem Tansen was written by Hazrat Inayat Khan, and the poem has 23 couplets, and the rhyme scheme of the poem is AABB. The figures of speech in the poem are simile, alliteration, metaphor, inversion, tautology, onomatopoeia, and transferred epithet. The central idea of the poem is music is to the soul what natural food is to health. The poem talks about teacher-student relationship through the medium of learning, music. Tansen is praised by King Akbar, who wants to meet Tansen's guru, Swami Haridas. For your assignment, you have warming up on page 105, and then you have questions at the side on page 106 and 107, and then you have the English workshop on page 108. Thank you.